out of the woods. Let's go for a fly in the tiger moth. This one is in camouflage and there's two people on board. The pilot sits in the rear seat. I don't remember the graphics being this good. This is Cliffs of Dover Blitz. Look at that. Look at that trail there. That smoke trail. It's hot smoke. It's the engine. I've selected complex engine management, so maybe it's not like that. I've got it at full throttle. Reduce the throttle a bit. Crescent wooden dashboard there. What's my speed? Approaching 80 miles per hour, I think, if I'm interpreting that correctly. What's my altitude? What does that say? Does that say 5,000 feet? 4,800. 4,700, so I'm at about 5,000 feet, that's pretty high. Let's pull back on the throttle completely. Let's have a look outside. And I'm just going to turn off the track IR. There we go. So this is what we're flying. Check out the exhaust. Do you recall seeing this? This must be a Blitz feature. I don't recall seeing this before. Is it realistic? Would a Tiger Moth's engine produce that much flame? I gotta say, it looks awesome. You know, it looks awesome. And I've got the engine at idle here. So we've got the exhaust. Excuse me, we've got the exhaust flame, and we've got the exhaust soot trail, or whatever you call it, smoke trail. Looks like the damn thing's on fire. Looks like burning oil, doesn't it? That's probably what it is. Maybe I'm not using the mixture correctly, or maybe that's just how it looks. But anyways, that's a pretty interesting feature there. There's a stalk. Looks like we're in Dover. There's the white cliffs. I'm up at about 4,000. I'm at 3,100 feet. 3,000 feet there with the engine at idle. And now I'm gonna put it into a bit of a spin. I tried this before off camera and I got into an uncontrollable spin, which I didn't think was very realistic. Normally just a tap on the rudder, nose down, and some engine power is going to get you out of a spin. Just recover without any issues at all, like I recovered then. But I put it into a prolonged spin from about 4,000 feet and I couldn't recover, and I crashed into the ground without exploding, and the broken plane was just sitting in a field. Which is, in a way, that's good. I was expecting the crash model to completely explode the plane unrealistically, but all it did, there's full throttle, all it did was bump the plane down in a field in a broken state, which is consistent with how it would be colliding with the ground after a spin that one had failed to pull out of. So there's the radar over there. I've already been there in a previous clip, so I'll just go somewhere else. I'm going to try and find an airfield and land. So cruise. So obviously it's a fixed pitch propeller, so it's not a constant speed propeller, and maximum RPM is to be 2600 on the tachometer there. We're at 2200 full power right here, so I'm going to bring it back to maybe 18 or 1600. A little too low. Let's just keep it there and monitor it, I guess. If the plane flies, it flies. Might be a little bit low. The RPM just keeps dropping of its own accord. To advance the throttle. Let's give it full power. There's a country villa, the Darling Buds of May. We're in southern England here, probably in summertime, I would say. And there's a water tank in the centre of that Tudor farmhouse. There's water tanks everywhere in this game. Alright, so let's find an airfield somewhere. Let's cover power. What's on the nose? Any airfields? I don't want to go to the coast. I want to go inland. And I can see blue flame coming out of the exhaust there. That engine does sound quite good from a distance. Up close it's a bit more Murray. Then continues to be like the Walmart. And then when it gets further away it goes good. Like that. Has that guttural sound to it. That sort of wavering guttural sound. Another one of those farmhouses and I can't look left very much on the track IR. So this is the De Havilland Tiger Moth. It's a pretty good plane. It's a classic plane. Maybe I should just try and land it in that field. What do you reckon? Because I'm not finding any. I can't see any airfield, and my map's not working. I don't know why. Maybe I selected the map not to work or something. But in real life, if you just try and land in a field, you'll probably get a rock or a barbed wire fence or something. The whole purpose of this vid is to demonstrate a little landing. Sort of a touch and go for you. Alright, now let's get out of here. Yeah. Just. You don't know how close that was. Sheesh. So I did a touch and go in a field, that was pretty good. You feeling lucky? How about another one? Lead off some of that speed. Someone in one of my other bids was saying that I was oversteering. I don't think he understood.
Bullshit.
Oh no, that I was trying to bleed off speed in that approach. I just gave the full power there. So, you can see that the engine noise is decoupled from the motion of the propeller. That's at full idle. That's at idle. And this will go, I'll go full power. That's at full power right there. So you can see, as I say, the engine is decoupled from the propeller. The engine noise is decoupled from the movement of the propeller. The propeller is going a little bit too slow given that I'm running at full power here. The aircraft's shaking around like the engine's going at full power. But the propeller is just doing a sloth-like motion. So I guess that's one useful thing that comes out of that that crash there. Let's hope you enjoyed that. That's the Tiger Moth.